we have Rob Gilly Dean versus Steve Twinkletoe Casey's coming up next.
Great name.
My name is Robbie Dean. I'm a cabinet maker and I'm 20 years old. I wanted to get a fight quickly and Alta was the quickest way to do it. I done boxing for 2 years and that's it really, nothing more.
What's your favourite submission?
I like the guillotine, that would be my favourite one.
Who's going to be tuning in to watch and support you?
My best friend Ricardo and his family and also my family as well.
What's been the toughest part of getting ready for your fight?
Definitely the diet, keeping eating healthy food and definitely getting up early in the mornings as well.
Who's your favourite MMA fighter?
Probably Francis Ngannou. I like how much of a powerhouse he is. So I like Francis Ngannou.
So my name is Stephen Casey. I'm 29 years old and I'm currently working as a sales rep for Heineken. I chose to train Alta for the simple reason that I feel I had plateaued in my training, laziness had crept in, wasn't getting up off my arse to do anything, and this was. There's nothing like getting you up off your hole like someone trying to punch you in the face for 9 minutes. So get up 6 a.m. every morning, in here for an hour and a half. It's great, absolutely fantastic. So it's been my big reason for training Alta. So for years before I started to train Alta, I was playing rugby as a scrum half. Absolutely loved it. Unfortunately, the game outgrew me. They all got bigger. I didn't. My growth spurts never came actually. So I suppose I decided if I wanted to do something competitive and combative, I suppose I better start picking on people my own size or something like that. So that was kind of a big reason as to another reason I decided to train Alta. I would probably say the ground game would probably be my favourite element of everything we'd say to do with mixed martial arts. Again, my size is fairly diminutive, so we're all about the same size lying down. His arm can hit me from the same place I can hit him, so on the ground fighting I'd say would definitely be my favourite aspect of the whole thing. So I suppose watching in my fight, I suppose I'd have to say my friends and family, I suppose my nervous girlfriend will definitely be watching on. She's probably not watching actually, probably in through guided fingers and hands, so if she can see this, it's going okay, I'm not dead. And I suppose family, mum, sister, father, all that, and I suppose everyone who I used to work with out in Spain, they've all said they're going to tune in, hoping to see me get a few digs, I suppose, but hopefully in the end, hopefully they're hoping I'm successful in this, so I suppose they'll all be watching on, so shout out to all of them as well.
I suppose, and now, in the red corner, Rob Gilly Dean! And in the blue corner, Stephen Twinkletoes Casey!
And here we go, guys.
It's one of the ones I've been looking forward to as well, particularly so.
And you explained to us before that Rob needs to stay behind his jab, right? Pepper him.
Yeah, he's a big jab. He's long reach. He can just get forward behind that and work that.
So we see the twinkling of the toes of Stephen Casey here.
And he's well in life.
It was a good attempt at the takedown. Good footwork from Rob to sidestep that like the matador.
Wow. Walk quick, hand
in
pose.
Let's
go
over the shoulder.
No, that's outside. He's out yet.
Well, that's the first test of Stephen Casey's guillotine defense.
Yep.
Past with flying colours. He's a guard top at the moment.
This is exactly where Steve would want to be on the ground.
Yeah.
Well done.
And Rob has long legs. He could nearly close his guard twice, those legs are so long.
Steven is heavy on top as well. He brings his head to move off.
Yeah, doing a great job here.
He's creating space, though.
Rob made a very, very good attempt at a scissor sweep there. Just didn't lock down the balancing hand, the posting hand of Stephen on the right side. Now Stephen pushing Rob's head towards the fence here.
And Rob uses the fence to get up maybe.
Yeah. He should be up for him now.
Big shot. shot there, big shot.
So it's exactly where Stephen needed to be. We talked about already how much of a boxing advantage Rob has on the feet. And this is exactly where boxing is no good to you anymore on with your back on the mat.
Like the way Stephen just took it to where he wanted to fight, he wasn't too willing to kind of engage on the feet.
Was that a guillotine on the guillotine?
You get to the back here.
That was a saucy guillotine attempt. Some really nice wrestling from the two guys as well. What, leaving his neck exposed here one more time now.
You can land a knee here, maybe break or something.
So Rob went for a judo throw with a headlock, but unfortunately his head went outside his own feet in the backwards direction. Stephen was able to capitalize on that and score his takedown and get that top position.
It's a good open round for Stephen, kind of has where he wants it.
Significant ground and ground as well. Rob doing exactly what he needs to do by getting his feet back inside and just did enough there to get to the second round. He's really going to have to keep it on the feet at the start of this next round. Get the second round back on the scorecard so he can go towards the third and even it out.
Is there any danger when he's guillotine? He sometimes accepts the takedown too easy because he's going for the guillotine instead of trying to defend it at base.
How much of an insult would it have been if Stephen Casey had got to get seen on Rob Guillotine? He'd have to change his fight name.
Well, we definitely saw a very, very good first round, so I'm excited for the second one. Great submission attempts.
Yeah, good wrestling, good sweep attempts.
And fast
good
with
position.
It too, right?
Yeah,
very,
yeah,
very
yeah.
fast with it.
Get the jab away a bit more, and she's that movement. She's get away from wrestling. Stephen did well again. Stephen's very strong.
He is. That's that rugby background too, you know. Played in the scrum half, I believe. Looked like a prop forward there doing that takedown.
He's a lot of time to work with here now as well, like, big.
Leaving his neck exposed here, but Rob. Oh, he's got the single leg. If he drives, he's got it. If he drives, he's got it. Stephen showing good balance. Rob fighting the hands here.
Stephen looks strong in there.
Yeah, he's physically very, very strong. That's what I was saying to you in the warm-up. He's been wrestling with the heavyweights, the other rugby heavyweights in this season. I don't know what it is about rugby, but it just makes tougher men.
He eases his weight well, I find. Yeah,
he knows where to go. So Rob tried to use a sit out there to come out on that last exchange. Unfortunately, ended up in a compromised position. He's in cyclotron bottom, slightly facing the wrong direction right now. He needs to turn back into face Stephen. He needs to turn onto his right hip here. Dig the left underhook and get up onto his right elbow. Rob did say to me that he was enjoying the jiu-jitsu, but maybe hasn't had as much time as he'd like to perfect some of these escapes. Well, he is on his correct hip right here now. He's taking back in place. He's got back to a close guard.
He's staying active though. He's not just accepting positions either.
Very well done there. Now controlling the upper body posture here. He's looking for that scissor sweep again. So he's got the knee across. Now if he can control the right hand of Stephen.
Oh, he's full mount.
Stephen actually did a really slick guard pass there. That was lovely.
Stephen's going to be hard to displace here. He's just good balance, like, so he'll be heavy.
Rob's booking.
Yeah.
He's booking, but he needs to press on the hips. Forget about protecting against the punches. Just push on the hips and get the hell out of there.
Really, if you don't connect his left knee to his left elbow.
He has him there. Turns to the side.
Steven stays calm, just holds position and pull it to finish.
Dangerous but effective striking from Steven here. He's holding position really well. Rob is doing everything he needs to do to keep him in the fight.
Yeah.
Back to side control here now. A slightly better position for Rob, although it's not a great position. He's going to get his long legs back inside here now again for a close guard one more time. And he's going to see the third round here. This is a tough night in the office for Rob.
Yeah.
Steven doing exactly what he needs to do. Rob is just being frustrated because all he wants to do is he wants to land a good barrage of punches. He's just not being given a chance by Steven.
I mean, he got it to the third round, but you have to be careful because eventually these punches will get you.
Yep. Yeah.
He really needs team space this round early. He can't afford an early kick.
We saw him turning to the side, you know. So for a second I thought like that was it, like no problem.
No, I think he was actually attempting a knee to elbow escape rather than turning up.
Yeah.
But you're right, those positions don't look good, and if you're a referee standing over there looking out for the safety of the fighter, you're gonna make a call. You need to give the referee every opportunity to keep him with there.
Steven was very quick though getting in front of takedowns, like he's deceivingly quick dude.
Yeah,
like,
yeah. Twinkle toes, man. Twinkle toes. I told you that fight name is a perfect one for him, man.
Good that the two of you see the difference, you know, like, in going for it, you know, like.
He comes out! Yeah, too aggressive there, too aggressive.
I know exactly what that feels like. When you're the striker and you just want to land one good shot, you overcommit, and now your opponent just ducks under.
But beautifully done.
Yeah. Saw Steve Warren today, he saw it coming. It was lovely.
Now we've seen Rob try the scissors sweep a few times. He's actually quite good at getting his hips off to the side. He's got it again. Now what he's got to do is he's got to trap the arm that's over his left shoulder while he's sweeping. See, right now Steven is able to negate this sweep because he's able to put his right hand on the ground. If Rob can keep that right hand off the ground as he's attempting the sweep, then he will get it, and he'll get top position on this. Nice strike from bottom there. He's still got the scissor sweep going on here. Just got to keep that. He's got to keep that that left arm under control.
Yeah, that's really good. Yeah, that's probably the time you were talking about. The time he didn't have on the ground.
Yes. He's looking for a triangle attempt here also. You can see him controlling the wrist. He's going to bring his left foot over Stephen's right shoulder next. He's trying it. He's going for it. Stephen is aware. He's keeping his hips nice and low, keeping his head low also.
He's doing well, like he's not just accepting positions still, you know, even though he's not getting where he wants. He puts pressure on.
Shoulder into his face, shoulder into his jaw. That'll work from here on now. Be as low as you want. Now, big hand fist, get up there. That's it. You can lie there off, man. Lie there off his face.
We might have our own Colby Covington right here.
Just hope he doesn't become a Trump supporter.
Just don't give him the mic after.
We start calling up Matt Hughes. Oh, there's something to get a team.
That'd be something if you pull that out.
Yeah, 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 yeah. You can keep his name then. Yeah. And this is extremely frustrating for Rob. I know, he just wants to get back to his feet and throw hands right now. Doing good. He's got that scissor sweep again. Up, up. There we go. Right now, disengage.
And he's got a nice knee there.
He gets his chance eventually.
He needs to disengage here. He needs to get his friends in the inside and get the hell away from Stephen. Twinkle toes Casey's here.
And let's not forget he's one hell of a boxer. Might only take one punch.
That's all it takes. Yeah.
He needs to break.
He needs to separate. Knees are good, but this is not his range. What a great fight, guys. Well done. Fantastic. gotta fight that twice this section.
Sorry, OG. What were you saying?
No, it's another 3 great rounds in the bank. Hulk showing us the sign of affection there.
Enthusiasm speaking out of him.
Man, let's be honest, he just dominated the fight.
Yeah, like he took the fight where he wanted to go, like, took it to the ground, and he was very good there.
As we get ready for our